someone suddenly collapses in front of you, and if you see that person is unconscious, is not breathing, he does not have pulse, what would you do? It could be anyone. It could be your loved one, your family member, your friend, your colleague. You are definitely going to call an ambulance. What after that? Are you going to wait there helplessly? You are not going to help him because you don't know anything about emergency? We don't want that. Because we believe that every life is precious and every life deserves to be saved. So we want to train you in handling emergency situation, whether it is medical emergencies or accidental emergencies. So let's start to learn these techniques so that you become ready to help anyone who deserves the chance to live. Today we are going to learn about artificial respiration, which is also called rescue breathing. It's a part of CPR. We have already taught you how to recognize the cardiac arrest condition and the high quality CPR. If you have not seen that video, please go and see that video, then you watch this. Artificial breathing or rescue breathing is the process where we breathe into the mouth of the casualty so that he gets oxygen. To begin with, we have to first tilt the head down and lift the chin up. This is we do to open the airway. This is called head tilt chin lift method. Once you've done this, start giving artificial breathing. You can use a pocket mask to give this artificial breathing. This pocket mask is a barrier device which is available usually in factories or industries or workplaces. But this is not available at your home or maybe anywhere on the streets. So I'm going to show you how to use any napkin or your clean cloth to give artificial breathing. To begin with, you have to blow in to the mouth of the casualty this way. Pinch the nose with your index finger and your thumb, tilt the head down, breathe in and blow into the mouth of the casualty. You have to see for the chest rise. You see that the chest is rising, so it shows that your air and breath is going into the lungs. Once you've done this, you have to repeat the process two times, once again. Breathe in for 1 second. So this process has to be done twice after giving 30 times compression. So you give 30 compressions and after that, two times breathing, 30 compressions, two times breathing. This process has to be continued till the medical help arrives or the person shows any sign of consciousness or life. Save a life, make a difference.